Hello friends, today we are going to study first unit of NIOS Biology, Origin and Evolution of Life and Introduction to Classification. In this chapter, we will get to know about how the life was originated on Earth. How can we define evolution? Is there any practical basis behind these theories? What are visible signs of evolution? We'll solve all the questions without losing our track from the syllabus. I hope this will help you not only in exams point of view, but also from conceptual basis. So let's start. The Earth was in hot lava state when it separated from the Sun. No life would sustain this condition of Earth. It took approximately 1 billion years to be cooled down, but still the surface of Earth was very hot. But as water cycle started to continue, the situation changed. Since water began to accumulate into large water bodies, it was then the first time coesurvates began to exist, and thus first form of life came into existence. The first ones were small single-celled anaerobic organisms, also called as prokaryotes, which developed into large multicellular organisms like us by process called evolution. We are studying about ourselves because of the result of evolution. Otherwise, we would have remained lame, unconscious, single-celled, boneless, brainless, limbless, small, teeny, tiny organisms called bacteria. That's a lot of assuming. Let's move to the evidence side. Do we have anything to back up these kind of claims? The simple answer is yes, but the answer is not simple. So let's take a look at it. The scientist and biologist, So those people began to explain possible theories or appropriately hypotheses of origin of life, aka how life was formed on mother planet Earth. The most accepted theory was, or I should say is, the one which states that there were some chemicals present in oceans wandering around and around here and there. These chemicals included ammonia, methane and hydrogen gas mixed in hot water of water springs. Due to harsh condition like lightning, they just meshed with each other. And we know when two or more chemicals mesh with each other, then what happens? Yes. Chemical reactions. This led to the lots of rapid chemical reactions under hot and harsh conditions, which just continued till years and years, and centuries will not be an exaggeration. And suddenly, by an accident, large complex chemicals compound formed. They began to be surrounded by a lipid molecule, which are type of organic complexes. Thus formed their own inner environment, but still they are just piece of non-sentient chemical complexes. The interesting thing happened when nitrogen and phosphorus containing sugar molecules combined to form a storage device. Yeah, you heard it right, a storage device which was capable of storing information just like your memory card in your smartphone. That was the turning point, as these so-called complex substances started storing information of their own. Information like how to sustain in this harsh environment, how to capture or arrange food, and even how to sustain this information device called genetic material, aka DNA and RNA. So this is what the theory suggested. But you may ask, what about practical evidences to back up this theory? We had not had any practical evidences till mid-20th century, but the combined efforts of two scientists changed the course of history of this puzzle by performing an outstanding yet simple experiment. We'll learn about that too, but in next video. Till then, bye, take care. And yes, if you are cleared with the concept, then please subscribe to Indie Education Channel, the independent education channel based on syllabus yet concept oriented. Thanks for watching and keep sharing.